We live in a time where people have lost the ability to judge what is true and what is not. And if you want to call the pre-election era part of a Trump era, okay. But if you're looking at something on the internet and you think it's true and do not have the capacity to judge whether it's not true, that is another element, that is another ingredient in the recipe for disaster. So this Trump is a manifestation, the Trump era, where what is true and what is not is where almost that distinction is not made, where that has risen to high heights. I would claim those seeds were germinating long before. And it has to do with what people think is true after they read it on the internet, our susceptibility to this. And here's something else. Again, I hate to sound like a broken record, if anyone remembers what a broken record is, that in K-12, somewhere in there, rather than pouring knowledge into people's heads and declaring them to be educated for having done so, somewhere in there we need to train people how to think, how to analyze, how to interpret, recognize when sufficient data has been put forth to turn something that you might be skeptical about into something that is a newly established objective truth. That is not taught in the schools. This should be a class just on what science is and how and why it works. And that would transcend the physics class, the chemistry class, the biology class, the geology class, the general science class. This would be its own course. So that when you are college educated and some institution has declared you graduated and a learned member of society, if you turn around and say, I choose not to believe this emergent scientific consensus, no, you don't have that option. It's not how objectively established scientific truths are determined. It is true whether or not you believe in it.
It is true whether or not you believe in it.
Not something you want to be true or feel should be true, or something that you don't allow to be true because your religion prevents it or because your political philosophy prevents it. You don't have that option if it's an objectively established truth. And like I said earlier, that is the entire point of the scientific enterprise. Knowing what is true, what is not, and in particular, because like I said, scientists are humans too, and we have bias, and we have all the stuff that goes on with every other human in this world also touches scientists. So we built a system to double check against that. If I am biased, and my bias shows up in some result, because I took some data and not others, and I could have done it this way and not, somebody else is going to get famous for checking my result and showing that I'm wrong. Well, Tyson is wrong. He messed up here. And if it's shown that my bias did influence it, I get a demerit. That's not a real thing, but with the next time I have an interesting result and I want people to pay attention to it. So there's a huge cost if a scientist is somehow meddling with their data because they have an idea of what they want their data to show. It comes at a huge cost to their career. But even if they think they can get away with it, somebody else will ultimately find it. And if they show that it's wrong, then we don't have any result at all, and everybody's back to the drawing board. Objective truths. I'm thinking that's what any law or legislation should be based on. If you base it on anything else, then you are imposing what might be your personal truth. Your personal truth is everyone should fend for themselves and not get a government handout. Let's say you feel really strongly about that. Well, that's how you feel. And in a free country, go right ahead. If you want everyone else to feel that, that's politics. Fine. Go have that political discussion in the floor of Congress. And then the law that comes out will have political flavor to it. I don't have a problem with that. But if your law somehow pivots on something that is not scientifically true, you're building a house of cards where the first two floors look stable, but they're completely hollow and empty. And by the time you put on a third floor, the whole thing collapses. Nature is the ultimate judge, jury, and executioner of what is true.
Nature is the ultimate judge, jury, and executioner of what is true.